Well, I did have natural light, but then I guess the sun decided to nap. I don't know. You can't even see my bed. This is what dreams are made of. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm Allie, and you know, this is not everybody's cup of tea. So if it's not, I'm sorry. But if it is, hi, how are ya? Please enjoy. If you watched my last video, you'll know that I was binging The Sopranos. Well, we finished that like last week, something like that. And it has started something else. We're now a Lorraine Bracco fan. If you're unfamiliar, she plays Dr. Jennifer Melfi in the series. She is also Karen Hill in the movie Goodfellas, and she has a number of other movies that I have been watching. She is just the talent, the beauty, the brilliance, like that Gaga meme, like everything. Which is why I'm saying this is gonna probably be, this is 99% a video about her. Finished The Sopranos, enjoyed it. The only seasons that exist to me are 1 through 5, particularly season 5, episode 1 and season 2, episode 13. Because they are episodes that hold bits of the Jennifer Tony relationship. Spoiler, no, they don't ever get together. I know, but the chemistry, the tension, just, it was there. The love was there. If you also take away the fact that he is, you know, in the family and stuff and his job, we're not gonna look into that. We're gonna focus on how he is with her, but also because of how her character is, it could never happen and it never does, sadly. But those are some really good episodes. We're not even gonna mention season 6, doesn't exist. And that's about it. Yes, I enjoyed The Run. No, I probably will not be rewatching it. Oh, well, maybe. No. Moving on from Sopranos, I am now watching another show that has Lorraine in it, Rizzoli and Isles. She plays the mom to Rizzoli. She's pretty funny so far, still only in the first season. But I have watched plenty of her other movies, and I'm just like, how has no one else been talking about her? Like, Karen alone in Goodfellas, a queen. She has a book. We've ordered that. We're waiting for it. There is a lot of stuff in there. It talks about, at the time, her previous marriages, her custody battle, her battle with depression, going into therapy. She is an open book, I'm telling you. And I think I appreciate that so much more, because for me, I've always seen celebrities as like this like top pedestal where it's like they're almost untouchables. And honestly, they have so much money and they live far away and all this other stuff, security, they are untouchable. But it's also really nice to see celebrities who are very human, because at the end of the day, that's exactly what they are. They're human beings. They're happy, they're sad. Anyways, like, I'm rambling and it probably doesn't make sense, but if you get or understand that some celebrities are just different and they're still very like human and not so like goddess and god or whatever, I don't know, we stan a true queen, her power. What else can I say about Miss Lorraine Bracco? She's hilarious. She played multiple jokes on James Gandolfini in Sopranos. Whoopee cushion, and then he to her too. He would like moon her when it was her take in scenes. Also, let's talk about how at first she was approached with the role Carmela, and she was like, nah fam, done that, checked it, I want to play the therapist. And she did. I really was like spending a whole week thinking, what am I gonna do, what am I gonna talk about? And then it's like, it is my channel. If I want to talk about Lorraine, I can. That is where my life is right now. It's just spiraling with Lorraine. Recently watched her movie Talent for the Game. It's her and Edward James Olmos. She plays, I guess, like an exec. I don't know. It's a scout and him trying to recruit somebody, and she plays the girlfriend to him. Their part is very, it's not a rom-com-y because they don't really fall in love, but they're funny. And she looks very happy during the movie. I don't know. Everything else I feel like I've seen has been, there's always some sad part. Like, she did a movie called Getting Gaudy and it was very dramatic. She plays an attorney. She loses the case. Spoiler alert. So it's like, what the heck? Oh, Goodfellas, hello. She plays the wife to the mob, which is based on a true story, which was even cooler to learn about, might I add. There's something else that she's like sad. I don't know, I feel like everything I've seen, her characters don't have a happy ending. This video is all over the place because I was like, we're just gonna sit down and we're just gonna talk about Lorraine, how all you want to do is just watch anything she's ever been in, and it sucks because she hasn't been social media active since like November. Lorraine, please come back. We miss you. You have at least two stands out here trying to support you, ma'am. Come through. Oh God, The Basketball Diaries. She plays Leo's mom and he is like a heroin crackhead. It's so sad, the part that I watched near the end, because he's like begging her for money and she's like no, and he's like calling her a bitch and a whore and it's like, how could you do this? I'm your son. And it's just like that, like, yes, no, she wants to be there, but then she also knows that her son is a drug addict, so she can't necessarily, like, she doesn't want to enable him. Great work, because she's crying and I'm feeling so sad. Of course, I am sad that in Sopranos, she wasn't even in the last episode. What? And then found out that she was in the finale. She had a written piece, but then it was cut. David Chase, why? I've been talking for 10 minutes and somehow all of this I just want to trash, because it's like, who cares besides me? Ugh. Lorraine Bracco, we support you. We're going through your stuff. We think you are just chef's kiss, the talent, ma'am. Killing it, killing the game. The 90s were an era. I went into The Sopranos, watching The Sopranos for the main characters and like the story plot, and because other people were talking about it, I was like, sure, let's watch this. And I came out the other end a whole different person and a new fan of Lorraine Bracco, and I feel like she is not appreciated enough. So if you're watching this, thank you for watching this for however long this video is. And also do yourself a favor and watch Goodfellas. And then after Goodfellas, watch Getting Gaudy. It's also mob related. I guess Talent for the Game, even though that's not rentable. The other two you can at least find on Amazon Prime. But I guess if you're into like renting and you don't mind spending a couple of bucks, sure, why not? Okay, I'm gonna go now. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Bye. I don't know.